but.
You know, and there's so much bondage, and we that's what you're saying earlier about judging people. We're judging people by their bondage, and we forget we got so many shackles on ourselves we can't even walk.
Mm-hmm.
What's that song, Mary Mary?
Right.
You know.
See, and another one is like bondage that you want to stay where you at
because you're comfortable.
Right. That's bondage.
Mm-hmm.
Nobody say nothing to me, no correction, no rebuke. The first thing is like, I'm human or something like that.
Yeah.
That's a cry for your flesh to stay where it's at. We understand that you are human, you are flesh.
But don't use an excuse.
Right. We always, when we get in trouble that, I always feel like I'm not where I'm supposed to be. And I think that's good. Because when you say, well, I'm comfortable where I'm at, you're in trouble. Because you're going to begin to go back.
And think about most bondage. I would say 99% of most bondage, everybody will blame someone else for it.
Right.
I'm in jail because of my parents.
Right.
I'm overweight because McDonald's sells Big Macs. Am I right or wrong? I was drunk because that bar was open.
I made prison because somebody told on me.
You know, we, as soon as we accept that we are the one that defiled God, God never did anything out of us.
Yeah.
You know, it's like God was speaking to Peter. You don't make yourself, you know, when he was talking about in the beginning of chapter 10 of Acts, he's talking about eating the food that wasn't right. That's not what makes you wrong. It's what comes out of you that makes you wrong.
Right.
Not by what you put in your mouth, but what comes out of your mouth.
That was religion.
Yes.
Well, see, I mean, just like you know, just like coming up, you know, we get taught right from wrong, but it's the choices that we make that put us in a lot of the situations that we're in. But the Lord still to help bring us up out of the situation. Like whenever he told Jonah to go one way, he wanted to go the other way.
Yeah.
And then he ended up, you know, go where he wanted to go. So then, okay,
there's only one way, God's way.
Yeah.
And I like to say when I'm preaching, because I always say it to my kids, no means no, and yes means yes.
Yeah.
God says no, it's no. He says yes, it means yes.
Yeah.
And so many times we want to do it our way. That's just
ain't nothing to better than well.
But the worst thing we can do that when we are doing something wrong or did something wrong, don't see it's right. They say walk in the light as he is in the light. And if we confess our sins, he is faithful and just.
Yeah, and we always got to try to get out of that bondage. Not say, I'll get out of it later,
right.
And not use the excuse, well, I'm saved and I can do it one more time. You know, that's it. Okay.
I
want to do a closing prayer, and I want you to say prayers for some people out on the internet too that may be suffering from bondage.
All
right. Would
you? Father God, we just come before you, Father, just seeking your face, Father God. Father God, we just thank you for this time tonight, Father. Father, we just reach out to people, Father, in the world, Father God, that is going through bondage, oh Father. We just ask that you put your hand on, Father.
Yes, Father.
And free them, Father God, from their bondage, oh Father God. Father, we just ask that you continue to do your work, oh Father God, and us, Father, that we be lights here, oh Father God. Father God, we just pray that people begin to see Christ in us, Father. Father, we ask that we just search our hearts, oh Father, if anything that in our heart is not of you, oh Father, that has us in bondage, Father. We just ask that you continue your work in us, oh Father God. We just ask that you shine your light in our hearts, Father. And we continue to pray for the people on the outside, Father. We pray for the government, oh Father God. We pray for this state, Father. We pray for this place, Father God. We pray for peace, Father God. We pray for the peace of Jerusalem, Father. We pray for a spiritual awakening here in this place, oh Father God. That men become as you are, oh Father God, that they come to you, that your purpose be done here, Father God.
Yes.
Father, we just thank you for chapter tonight, Father, that you put on his heart to come out here, Father, and share your word with us, Father. That we just look at it as a spiritual ear here, Father God.
Yes.
Continue to bless his ministry, oh Father God.
Yes.
Continue to surround godly men and godly women around him, oh Father.
Yes.
Father, he needs help, Father God.
Yes.
Send him help, Father, right now in the name of Jesus.
Yes, God.
Father, we just pray that you sanctify this place, oh
yes.
Father. As we leave, Father, that you keep us, Father God, in your way, Father. Father, we pray for our families. We just ask that you continue to put godly men and godly women around, Father. And the ones that don't know you, Father, we pray that you draw them to you, Father.
Yes.
We pray that you use us, Father, in a mighty way. Father God, the ones that do know you, Father, we just ask that you continue to strengthen, Father. Put your hand of protection around, Father God. Father, we just thank you for all that you've done, all that you're doing, Father. And we give you all the praise and the glory. We just pray in Jesus Christ's name and the church's sake.
Amen. Amen.